Hello everyone. Let's look at these sentences. Mumbai is bigger than Surat. Mumbai is more expensive than Surat. Mount Everest is the highest mountain in the world. Well, yesterday I posted a video on our Fluentlingua YouTube channel explaining degrees of comparison. And after watching that video, some friends and some students, they requested more details. So today I am taking the same topic but giving some more details about degrees of comparison. Now I am sure you know that degrees of comparison, they are used for either adjectives or adverbs. If you have any doubts about adjectives or adverbs, you can watch our video, Parts of Speech. In that we have clearly explained what nouns and adjectives and verbs and adverbs are. So degrees of comparison. We know that there are three types of degrees: positive, comparative and superlative. Now we need to know whether an adjective requires ER, EST, like bigger, biggest, or whether it requires the words more and most. Now how to decide what particular adjective or adverb requires either this or that? So a very simple rule to remember is, if the adjective or an adverb is monosyllabic, that means it is spoken with one breath of air. For example, when you say big, tall, fast, so such words are monosyllabic. So such words in comparative and superlative will require ER and EST. So big, bigger, biggest, tall, taller, tallest, fast, faster, fastest. Very easy. Now if your adjective or an adverb is polysyllabic, that means it has more than one syllables. So when you pronounce that word, if you have more than one breath required, then it will require more and most for comparative and superlative. For example, when you have a word like beautiful, so beautiful, there are three syllables. So in that case, you will require more beautiful and most beautiful. If the word is interesting, so interesting, so that will require more and most. More interesting and most interesting. Expensive, expensive, three syllables. So such polysyllabic words will require more and most for comparative and superlative degree. Now, with that background, let's try to understand actual comparisons. Suppose there are two items compared, only two items. Then you can say, for example, here there are two trees, and you can clearly see that tree A is taller than tree B. Similarly, here you can see two boxes, A and B. Now here box A is bigger than box B. Now the same situation can be described the other way around. You can say tree B is not as tall as tree A. Or you can also use the word as. So tree B is not as tall as or so tall as A. Similarly here box B is not so big or as big as A. So this particular this type of sentences are used only when you have two items in comparison. You are comparing only two items. But when you have more than two items, then there are two possibilities. For example, in a situation like this, where only one item is different from the rest, then you can say, for example, if these are marbles, then you can say marble A is the biggest marble of all, right? So A is the biggest marble of all. That is superlative. Now, suppose I say A is bigger than any other marble. That also conveys the same message. And I can also say no other marble is as big as A. So here, three sentences. A is the biggest marble, A is bigger than any other marble, and no other marble is as big as A. All these three sentences convey the same message. Now, if I have a situation like this, in which three things are equal here, or a small set of things are equal and they are different from the rest. So in here you can see marbles A, B and C, they are bigger than the rest. So you can say, for example, let's take A. So A is not the biggest, but one of the biggest marbles. The same sentence you can use for B also. B is one of the biggest marbles, or C is one of the biggest marbles. But right now we are interested in A, so we are saying A is one of the biggest marbles. Now in comparative form, we can say A is bigger than, we cannot say any other, because in that case for B and C the sentence will be wrong. So we have to say A is bigger than most other marbles. And in positive, we can't say no other marble is as big as A, because it will be wrong for B and C. B and C are equal to A. So in that case, we have to say very few marbles are as big as A. So superlative, A is one of the biggest marbles. Comparative, A is bigger than most of the marbles. And very few marbles, and actually here we can see only two marbles. Very few marbles are as big as A. Now that is grammatical structure, but what about the use? So from the use point of view, this first pattern is used for factual statements. So for example, when you say Mount Everest is the highest mountain in the world, it is the tallest peak in the world, nobody is going to challenge that, it's a fact. So when one item is different from the rest, it is more like a factual situation, and in that situation you will use this kind of sentences. And when you are giving your opinion, for example, when you say Sachin Tendulkar is one of the best cricketers, so it is your opinion. So those who have some other cricketers in their mind, they will not take any objection. They will accept that because their cricketers are also taken care of. But if you say Sachin Tendulkar is the best cricketer in the world, then some people may not accept that. So when you give your opinion, then usually we prefer this kind of sentences, right? So a final point, when you say big, bigger, biggest, fast, faster, fastest, that's not a problem. But apart from that, there are quite a few adjectives and adverbs where irregular forms are used. Now what do I mean by irregular? Irregular means they don't follow either er, est or more and most pattern. They are different. So for example, a word like good. For good, the comparative form is better and the superlative form is best. So good, better, best. Similarly for bad, we have worse and worst. Another irregular pattern is for a y ending adjective or adverb. So when the adjective or adverb ends in y, then we convert y into I and then add er and est. So for example, costly becomes costlier and costliest. Similarly, happy, happier, happiest, right? So after watching this video, you should be able to say, I am the happiest man in the world. I hope this video helps you. And if you want more such videos, please visit www.fluentlingua.com. You can also visit our YouTube channel Fluentlingua. Thank you very much. I'm Dharmendra Sheth from Surat.